Hello all, welcome to the YouTube channel of Chamele Baby Institute of Pharmacy Indo. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about qualitative test for phenols. First of all, if we talk about phenols, phenols is a hydroxyl group on an aromatic ring, or simply the hydroxy derivative of aromatic compounds are known as phenol. Phenols are weaker acids than carboxylic acids. It undergoes substitution reactions readily and is one of the most versatile and important industrial organic chemicals. So the test of phenols are very important because they are having high industrial importance. First of all, if we talk about the qualitative test of phenols, then there are a number of tests. Among them, the litmus test, perchlorate test, Lieberman test, bromine water test and thallium dye test are the main. The first one, litmus test. If you talk about the litmus test is used to determine the acidity or basicity of any compound. If a particular litmus paper which is having blue color, if it dipped into the acid solution, then it turns that paper into red, and if red paper dip in the basic solution, then the litmus paper turns blue. It shows the importance of acidic or basic nature of the compound. Now, the red litmus paper turns blue while blue litmus paper remains unchanged in the presence of a base. Phenol turns blue litmus paper red. This shows that phenol is acidic in nature. If we talk about the carboxylic acids also, then carboxylic acids do all give this test also. And compared to carboxylic acid, phenol is weakly acidic and it does not give an effervescence with the aqueous sodium carbonate solution. The second test is the ferric chloride test. Ferric chloride, that is FeCl3 test. Aqueous solution of the phenols reacts with the freshly prepared ferric chloride solution and they produce colored complex. And most phenols give dark colored solutions. And so this is one of the characteristic test for the identification of phenols. For example, the different phenols produces different coloration on reaction with the ferric chloride solution as listed in the table which is on the slide, like phenol, resorcinol, orthocrisol, paracrisol, they produce violet or blue coloration. Catechols produces green coloration, hydroquinone violet or transient blue color, and pyroquinols blue which is rapidly changing to red. So this is the one of the main important test, and the basic reaction is as shown in the slide. Phenol, when react with the FeCl3 solution, it produces a violet colored complex which is of the Fe(C6H5)3- plus thrice HCl plus 3H+, if we talk about the complete balanced equation when you are taking six moles of the phenols. So this is all about ferric chloride test. Now the next test is the Lieberman test. Phenol reacts with the concentrated sulfuric acid and sodium nitrite and forms a yellow colored quinone monoxime complex. This monoxime complex produces color. With the excess of phenol and sulfuric acid, a deep blue indophenol complex is formed, and on dilution a red color indophenol is formed which turns to deep blue color sodium salt solution of indophenol on treatment with the sodium hydroxide. The reaction is as shown in the test, and this test is given by phenols which contain a free para position. So this is one of the important tests again, Lieberman's test. Then next is bromine water test. Phenol undergoes electrophilic substitution reaction with bromine. When bromine water is added to aqueous solution of phenol, the brown color of the bromine disappears and white precipitate of the tribromophenol is formed. As shown in the slide also, the reaction is as such. Phenol, when react with the bromine, it produces tribromophenol which is of having white precipitates or white turbidity, and that can be shown in the test tubes as shown above. Next is the thallium dye test. Phenol on heating with the phthalic anhydride in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid forms a colorless condensation compound called phenolphthalein. On further reaction with the dilute sodium hydroxide solution, it gives a pink color fluorescent compound called fluorescein, and that's why the test is otherwise known as fluorescein test. Characteristic colors are here produced by different phenolic compounds, and which can be we can look under a white background. And the reaction is as follows: phenol, when react with the phthalic anhydride in presence of H2SO4, produces phenolphthalein, which is first of all colorless in nature when treating with the NaOH. In the excess of the NaOH, it produces pink color, and when you are again adding more of the NaOH or excess of the NaOH, it again goes to the colorless solution. And the different phenols give different colors in the phenylphthalein dye test. For example, phenol produces reddish pink, orthocrysol red, metacrysol blue or violet, 1-naphthol green, 2-naphthol fan green, resorcinol yellow green fluorescence, hydroquinone deep purple color. These are the colors which are produced in the phthalein dye test. There are some of the extra precautions which you need to be take while you are going to identify phenols with the help of these tests. For example, whenever you are taking FeCl3 solution, it should be prepared freshly and should be neutral and very dilute. The phenols is very toxic in nature and corrosive in nature. It can produce skin problems. So whenever you are taking phenol, you have to take it with care. Bromine should not be inhaled because it causes irritation. It causes so much irritation, and it is very harmful for our body. So whenever you are having bromine, it should be carefully taken. Concentrated ashes should not be handled in improper manner, or you should be very careful while using concentrated acid. Otherwise the harm can occur. So these are the precautions whenever you are going to study phenols or identifying phenols. You should follow these precautions. Thank you all.